You're watching 8-bit days a week, and continuing my testing of other PlayStation games running on the PlayStation Classic, a modded one, of course. Today I'm playing Polyphony Digital's, yes, that Polyphony Digital, the same guys responsible for Gran Turismo, and here is Omega Boost. It's a cult classic, I guess. Oh, and as with my testing, I won't be really doing a lot of tweaking. I want to see how it fares with minimal tweaking. I just enabled there to show FPS, just so you have an idea how good or bad it runs. Okay. And looks like I'm running on 50 frames per second here. Because maybe my ISO is the PAL version? I actually cannot tell. Oh yeah, it looks like it is PAL version. No, wait, it's just like a different resolution. And yeah, look at that. You can clearly see that there are some problems here. It's not as smooth as we want. Alright, it is on a solid 50 frames there. I could have sworn I was running the Japanese version, but okay, maybe I got a different BinQ file here. And I never got to finish this game. It got really sort of impossible for me already at the later stages. Wasn't really good enough back then. Maybe with the resume points I could get better. Practice it a lot, I guess. Finding a mech game back then, a good mech game back then, was really difficult. Not a lot of mech games played this well. Usually it was a slog or something. Then of course there is the Armored Core series. Maybe I could try that soon. It's another game that is already in the Japanese version of the PlayStation Classic, Stock 20, but not here. Even at a 50 frame per second there, it does play at the speed I actually remember. So maybe this game really is just 50 frame per second. That sounds weird, I know, but I don't know. Because this is exactly how I remember it. Not faster, not slower. Of course, it's possible I was also playing like a PAL title before, but I doubt it. I'm pretty certain that was an NTSC version that I was playing before. Come on, let's go. That took a while. I never did understand the story of this game. I know it involves some sort of time travel. Of course, this is one of those games that I just go ahead and play it straight away. So far, everything works great, actually, on the PlayStation Classic. No graphical problems. The speed is okay. I'm just really confused why it's coming up as 50 frames, though, but it's still exactly as how I remember it. If you guys think that this should be running faster or something, please do let me know in the comments. Because I can't really...
Be careful.
Can't really recall at this moment. Does it definitely looks okay to me? And I would say that I played this quite a number of times, not just unlike some of the titles where I just tried it once, like in a friend's house or something. If you like third-person, well, not exactly a third-person shooter here, but it's a behind-the-back, on-rails shooter. Kind of like Star Fox, I guess. But you're not on a R-Wing, you're in a giant robot that throws multiple missiles there, a la... Macross. And of course I love Macross. You'll probably notice with most of the games I've currently loaded, there's a lot of titles that feature giant robots. And if you haven't tried this out, I really encourage you to do so. if you don't have the Classic, I think this is available on the PSN. And it's one of those things that, you know, sometimes I wish Polyphony Digital would revisit. Of course, they're busy as it is enough with the Gran Turismo series, but this is a title that I would definitely not forget and would still play from time to time. And that's it. We're going down to the planet now. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. This is you're watching 8-Bit Days a Week. Please do like, comment, and subscribe. Catch me more for videos of me testing out PlayStation games on the PlayStation Classic. Let's see how it goes. Thanks for watching.